All right, guys, we're back here with our next installment of X's and O's with FLG. All right, today we're going to be talking about one of our favorite drills here at FLG that really works on skill development while teaching one of our principles in the open clear, and that is the breakout. Okay, so first thing we're going to talk about today is breaking out to get open, all right? A lot of midfielders, right, we're doing this drill, we're getting some good skill work in, we're not understanding how to get ourselves open on a breakout off a save. Okay, we're going to talk a little bit about understanding our levels of the clear and our spacing. Okay, and then of course using the proper hands and getting to the right areas of the field. So the first thing we're going to do is both goalies are going to be in the cage. So each goalie is going to start with a ball here on either side. When the goalie calls break, okay, we talked about earlier in our developing the open clear, we make a big point of emphasis on making our middies go opposite the box. Okay, so our middies, wherever they are, we don't necessarily want them on the opposite the box side. We want them to have to think about it. So sometimes we'll have them guard people first, but one midi again should be breaking short, 3 yards, and over their shoulder, the outside of the field. The other midfielder on the field, we want him to kind of run deep, still looking over his shoulder, right? Still looking over his shoulder, but he's going to get above the top of the box and then make his way to the sideline, okay? Really, really important. That three and out, that's going to be probably the most likely the pass that we may hit with the goalie, okay? So we want that to be, as we go to break out, to be a hard step, and snap your head around so you can back and look over your shoulder to the goalkeeper and make eye contact, okay? Goalies, you have the option of being able to hit those midfielders every now and then just to make sure you keep them honest, okay? Our D guys are going to be bananaing out, okay? They can keep their sticks in their strong hand, okay? We tell them this because for the most part, they shouldn't be getting that ball on the check down unless they're not handling pressure. Our long stick midi, who traditionally in our clear gets off the field, he's still going to carry up the field and then get out to the sideline, okay, looking over his shoulder. And our last D guy, okay, he's going to wait for this ball to get outlet. So each goalie is going to outlet a ball to the sides here, okay. Our third defenseman, that's our whole defenseman, right? He's our check down guy in case something, there's a press down or something like that, or maybe we drop a pass. We don't want to have a one-on-one with the goalie. He is now going to make his way off to the box side, all right? And now it's a simple ladder drill up the side of the field. So now we're going to be going over the shoulder, and as this guy continues his route, we should be making one pass here, and he's going to relay it now to that long stick midfielder. We want to make sure that our guys are outside the hash marks, right? The idea of the clear is to try and make sure that we use the areas of the field, use the whole field, the width of it, okay? And now we're going to be doing the same thing. Defenseman, okay? When we're on this side of the field, we will use our outside hands, right? So on this side, going this way, we'd have to use our left hands. Everybody on this side should be going left-handed. Everybody on this side should be going right-handed to make sure we get balanced skills. Right? I think that too often at the youth ages, we worry more about clearing the ball and worried about getting it out than we do teaching our young defensemen how to be able to handle that ball with your offhand. That's a really, really important skill at the next level, okay? Once this second set of midfielders captures the ball, they are now going to progress into the box, and Coach Corey is now going to talk to you a little bit about what we do with the ball once it enters the offensive half.
All right, how you doing, guys? I'm going to talk a little bit here about what happens after that ball enters the offensive half. We got a couple teaching points that pretty much all apply to attackmen or attackers, depending on who's running the drill. For this particular drill in our two-ball breakout, we're actually going to utilize four attackers as opposed to only three. So we'll have one, two, three, four attackers, and again, we have two balls coming into play in this specific drill. So as our midfielders, right, or our long stick middie start carrying the ball into the box, the first teaching point that we have to emphasize with our attackers is to make sure that they V-cut, but they V-cut to space. So we don't want a nice small V-cut where they're not really getting any progress there. They're basically just cutting right back to where they started. We want to make sure that the attackers who are going to receive that pass on the outside are V-cutting to a place where they can kind of free up their hands and actually be able to receive that pass. So now they're in a position to receive the pass with their stick to the outside. So the attackers on this side are going to catch it with the stick in their left hand. Our attackers on this side are going to catch that ball with the stick in their right hand, making sure that, again, it's to the outside. So for the younger players, and a youth modification that we say is really, really important for our attackers is to make sure the stick is always to the outside. So for example, this attackman right here receives that pass with the stick in the left hand. Instead of bringing that stick across the body and then talking about swinging it through X or even catching that ball to the outside and throwing it across their face, we like to say you have to catch to the outside, plant, protect your stick, roll away, keeping that stick to the outside, switching hands, and then we're going to swing that ball through X. So the next stage of the drill for our attackman is getting that ball through X. Again, they're going to switch hands, they're going to roll to the outside, and now once their hands are free, they're going to be in a position to get that ball to our attackers or our attackmen who are waiting right here at X. Again, same thing. Our attackmen at X have that stick to the outside. This attacker right here, stick in the left hand. This attacker right here is going to have that stick in the right hand. Now, as soon as those attackmen at X receive that pass, the first thing that we want to do is attack opposite. We want to go where there's a lot more space and where we can maybe generate some step down looks or even some flash cuts across the crease. So once these attackmen right here have that ball, because it was then transferred from the guys on the wing, they're going to immediately start driving to the opposite side of the cage, just like that, with that stick to the outside. So now this attackman who caught it with that stick in the left hand, they're turning to the outside, and they're attacking to the right hand. Vice versa with this attackman right here, okay? So we are now swinging through X, and we're driving opposite. Now our wing attackman right here, after that move that ball through X, we never want to stand still. We talk about off-ball cuts because the more active we are off-ball, especially in transition when there's a lot going on, the more open looks we typically get. So we're going to swing that ball through X and we're going to immediately backdoor cut on both sides of the field. So now we have attackman driving opposite and we have attackman driving opposite, and then we have our wing attackman cutting through, one, to create space for the person that's dodging, but two, to maybe generate a look for ourselves. So we actually talk about these cuts off ball as a variation of a two-man game, because in reality they're really working together, because once this attackman right here drives opposite, that looks going to be right back to that original wing attackman that gave them the ball when we were swinging it through X. Same thing here. We got this attackman right here driving opposite, and they're going to get a look right here. Very important that these two attackmen that converge avoid one another. I actually really like that they're kind of running at each other, because they have to learn to catch in traffic with their head up, make sure to maybe even make a move. And the last piece, which is that timing, you know, we got to make sure that they're cutting and converging at the same time so they can receive a pass in a good spot. But also, we want to make sure that we're finishing in front of the cage, right? So we never want to shoot outside the pipes. We want to make sure that our attackmen get to this area of the field before they release a shot. That allows them to get more angle, it allows them to move the goalie, and allows them to either fake to the near pipe and shoot to that far pipe, or maybe even do the opposite there. So there's a lot of variations you can do out of this. The most simple one is quickly moving it through X, backdoor cutting for a feed on that back pipe. So in later videos, we'll give you some of those variations to work on in the two-man games. But for now, this is our two-ball breakout drill that resembles our open clear.
Guys, just one more point of emphasis, right? Do about a half a bucket of balls going in one direction, and then have your goalies jog to the other end and have it coming back in the other direction so that both the middies and the defensemen get to work with both their strong and weak hands.
After these four attackmen go, they're out of the drill. Next four guys come on. So while you might have, you know, 8, 10, 12 attackmen at practice, you're cycling through groups of four really quickly. So it's a good drill to get a lot of guys involved and work on your full field clear. Thank you very much, and we look forward to seeing you guys on our next installment of X's and O's with FLG. Have a great day.